following that epic session with Neil Fairclough, we've managed to grab some time with Rufus Tiger Taylor, currently playing percussion and drums, backing vocals on the Queen and Adam Lambert tour. How's it treating you?
Amazing. A dream. Absolute dream.
So, I mean, did Roger just say, right, you know, do you want the gig? How did it work out? Did you kind of audition? I mean, it sounds silly, but...
What was it? He just said he needs some backup, really. And I've done a few things with Brian in the past, and so he was more than happy to... exercise that idea.
So everyone
was just kind of really cool about it, and we did a few rehearsals, and yeah, we did that, obviously the Eastern European.
Yeah, that must have been kind of bonkers. That was
terrifying. Absolutely terrifying, but brilliant, so much fun.
I think it's clear from when I watched the side stage, you are enjoying yourself.
Definitely enjoying myself.
But you're playing an arena tour, aren't you?
Yeah, so you've got to enjoy yourself, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. So, did you just going back from the start? I guess did you just naturally end up playing drums? I know it's a coincidence with what your dad did, or did he didn't not say push you, but yeah, was it something that just happened?
Yeah, they were always around the house, so it was very easy to hit things loudly. But I just love doing it from a really young age. I've just actually recently just seen all these. My mum's just converted all her old childhood videos into DVDs. There's a video of me of like, I don't know, one or two or something, you know, sat behind a drum.
Just bashing away.
Just going for it. So I've always really, really liked it. But I think about 12 was the age I could actually make them sound all
right. Right, cool. Did you have lessons? I know it sounds like you, from what your father does. Did you have lessons at all? Is it all self-taught or?
I'd say mostly self-taught. I did go to drum tech in Acton for a year.
Right.
I'm a terrible student with anything. I don't know why. I get very easily distracted.
Right.
And I did learn some things. I got to take some kind of tricks away from that. But mostly sort of.
From someone who's not a musician, how do you differ from the way Roger plays to you? Because I've heard you hit hard. I can see that. Because I talked to Nige.
Yeah.
Drum tech and.
Well, Dad used to hit a lot harder.
Right.
But he can still hit them.
Yeah.
When the adrenaline goes going, he's he still goes for it. But I was influenced, well, obviously a lot by him, but a lot by Taylor Hawkins. And Dave Grohl.
I mean, I guess from your age, that would make complete sense. They are that generation, that kind of.
And the dad,
to have those two drummers like that in one band.
Yeah, it's insane.
I mean, to be Taylor Hawkins, you've got to be good, haven't you?
Absolutely. To play for Dave, you have to be absolutely on the ball, yeah. But we've been fortunate because Dad's been mates with them before the Foo Fighters even, made it. So we've got to hang out over the years and stuff. Yeah, he's like my hero. He really is. I follow him. So I play.
He turned up in LA, didn't he?
Yeah, he rehearsals, did. Yeah. I think he's going to come to LA as well, the actual gig in the Forum. Vegas, maybe, as well. But he's a great guy. They're just amazing. Love his playing. I'm a mixture of, like, mainly Taylor, but I've definitely got a bit of Dad in me. A lot of Dad in me, actually.
Was there a first song that you could... The first song you played, or first song you got through playing drums, was the one you were practicing at.
For the Eclipse years ago,
right?
Like years and years ago. Can't remember how old I was, like 9 or 10 or something. I played. What did I play? I played. Oh my god, mind blank. Well, we did We Will Rock You, which was not the hardest.
oh no, what was it?
It'll come to me. I can't think right now. Rocking all over the world.
Status Quo?
Yes, sorry.
Well, it's Rocking All Over the World. Yeah, oh, it's a John Fogerty song. Yeah. Exactly. Oh, right, okay.
Yeah,
great.
That was like, I think that was one of the first.
I was expecting you to come up with some real cool song.
Yeah, that's brilliant. No, it was totally brilliant. It was because it's just like a really easy, very simple groove, but like really, you know, good. You need to know how to do that stuff.
So did you end up in bands with friends and all that
and
sort of thing?
Out. Sorry,
Wipeout. Okay, yeah. Cool.
Yeah.
So did you start with, like? Were you in a like pickup band with you with your mates or something? Were you?
I like tried to start a couple of bands at school and stuff. Had one with a friend I'm still keeping contact with. She's doing great right now. Coco Sumner. She's a singer, songwriter. Bassist, really cool musician. But we were in a little band at school together for a little while. But I think we did like 5 school concerts or something. But that was about it. But then obviously afterwards, straight after school, I started working.
So when you say working, was this sessions or was
sessions,
right?
Yeah. Brian gave me my first. Proper thing, gig. It was at the Royal Variety Performance.
Yeah, I remember that. It was the Wicked song, wasn't it?
Yeah,
Defying Gravity.
Taylor Hawkins did.
He did the drums, of course, yeah.
So I was over the moon about getting to imitate him, do you know what I mean? But just more session work after that.
So did Brian come to you, or did he talk to Roger and say, how does one obviously you've known Brian all your life, but how does one get?
I think he called me.
He just said
he was like, I need you to do this thing. Would you like to do it? I said yes, of course. But I was just about to do the last exams at the end of the year for drum tech. And I couldn't do it, so because I had to leave. That day to go do a sound check and then did the actual thing.
Right, cool.
So I never actually got my degree or whatever.
Can you not go back and toy it off or something?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you're in the middle we're in the middle of America at the moment. Well, like Brian went back a long time later and finished off
his...
He did, didn't he? So,
So
then that led to playing on the Anthem tour.
Yes. Yeah,
so you got to play lots of different styles of music on. Oh, you do with Queen, but on there it's show tunes and rock and roll and
kind of things, which is a really good learning experience for me.
Did you have a massive drum riser on that? Was it me? You seem to be really high up.
Yeah, I was quite high up.
Yeah, I thought you were.
And Brian, because the stages weren't as quite as big as
they were kind of theatres, weren't they? Yeah.
But so the drums were very loud on stage, so Kerry and Brian insisted on putting me in a glass box, for most of that tour.
I can't remember. I didn't remember, just
3 big.
Oh, sort of like not in front of you,
sheets
the side.
Of plastic or glass.
Oh, whatever. I see. Okay, I don't remember seeing that actually.
Yeah, in front. Well, yes, it's see through, mate.
Smart ass.
So you just basically get 3 different walls of really loud drums.
And you're in there. Of course, you're in there, aren't you?
Yeah, so it's quite deafening. But it was, the playing all the different types of songs that I wasn't really used to was a great learning curve and a lot of fun on that tour. First time I met Neil as well. So.
Of course, yeah, exactly. So what's he like to play with? There's a rhythm section. How
Neil,
do you two?
Oh my God, he's an absolute dream to play with. He's just... I mean, his... Queen, like, brain is ridiculous.
I know it is.
He knows more about this band than
they do.
Probably anyone, yeah. So it's very useful, like that, to have him in rehearsals and, you know, how's this guy again? And he's like, Neil.
Yeah,
he's like the Queen encyclopedia. But, he's amazing. He's amazing. Like, we really look forward to the times when we're just messing around during sound checks because usually he'll rip out some Tower of Power or something. Or
yeah,
do,
yeah.
Do like What Is Hip or like.
Oh, brilliant!
You know, yeah. Some cool funky stuff like between us. But yeah, he's awesome. He's like I've probably the best bass player I've ever played with.
Brilliant! He's a super nice guy as well, isn't he? Super joking around, nice he's just so nice to be around.
He has me on the floor all day long.
Sometimes he doesn't mean to though.
Oh no!
Because some of his jokes are of varying quality.
Yeah.
All day. But so you talked about sessions. Did you? Is there anyone you've played with in particular? Just anyone of any note?
Yes. But like like studio stuff and gigs. Well, the guy who stands out more than anything is the master, Jeff Beck.
I remember speaking to Roger about this. You know, he was saying, "Oh, because we started talking about Jeff Beck for some reason." I don't know why it came up. Maybe it's the Freddy Friday thing,
right?
And
yeah.
he said, "Oh no, Rufus has got. I'm going to do some work with him." I was like, "Wow!"
Yeah, it was insane. I mean, it was the first time we played was Dad was doing a gig in the country called Wintershall Festival. You know?
Yes.
Yeah, they did a big charity thing.
He did say it's not true, and
people get really
ready. And yeah, we remember putting them online. Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, and so it was like a 15-song set. Dad was singing the whole thing. We had a great band, and I was playing kit for the whole thing. And we were sort of at the end of the night, and everyone was freaking out that Jeff was going to come in and play. Like everyone was just, he didn't need rehearsals. He came in for about an hour, played like half of a song, and he's like, yeah, don't worry, I'll be all right.
Brilliant.
Like,
wow.
Of course he is, you know.
He's Jeff Beck, yeah.
Yeah, but that was really special that day. I really remember that. And then straight after the gig, we were, you know, jumping up and down, so excited. It was over and we made it.
Yeah.
And then he comes up to me and goes, do you want a job?
He's a nice guy as well, isn't he?
Super
I've
nice
met
guy.
Him once.
Like, the most just humble, generous, you know, everything. He's just modest.
Yeah.
Such a nice man.
Neil again, popping his head in. God, it's like Mr. Bean going around, isn't he?
It's literally it. Yeah, and I sort of laughed in Jeff's face when he said that because I did not take him seriously. But he was serious. He was like, no.
Wow.
Seriously, what are you doing next year? And I was like, I will, you know.
Nothing now.
I will do anything you fucking you ask. Excuse me. We did some studio stuff. I went over to his house. Did some studio stuff. Really cool. We haven't actually finished what we want to do. But we did like 8 tracks or something, and then we did that gig, and then the Savoy one. He wants to start doing it properly, but obviously we need to.
You've got this little thing going on at the moment.
Yeah,
got
to get this.
Yeah, you can family first.
Yeah,
exactly. Speaking of that, it's funny actually. With Roger's Fun on Earth album, you have a co-write.
Yep.
And I remember talking to him about that, and he said you were a little bit kind of embarrassed about it. And he was like, no, it's really nice. Yeah, let's do something with it.
No, it's nice. Yeah. I was just, I can't remember where he nicked it, but.
Sorry to interrupt.
Yeah.
It's all right, Paul.
I'm just showing you why not, but you're still.
Yeah, sorry, you're nearly done. It's okay.
I'm just going to trip up. Yeah, no, I started.
Neil again. Spike's in the room as well.
Spikey?
Hey!
There he is.
Knackered. I was playing it on the piano. I come up with random little, you know, very short, little pieces on my own sometimes, and I just started playing it, and he walked past, and he goes, "Oh, I like that."
The impression of your dad.
Yeah. I was like, He's like, can you come upstairs and.
Record
it. Yeah. I was like, oh, okay. Where's this going? and then he obviously turned it into what it is. But I thought it was really nice.
It was lovely. Yeah, really. Yeah, it's very cool.
Jason Falloon played guitar on it, and he's awesome. Such a great player. Really gave it the extra kick it needed.
There's that, and then you get a little spot during the Queen show in the sense that. you get behind the kit to tie your mother down as a little treat to unleash, don't you?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, look forward to that a bit, I'm sure.
I definitely
do. Yeah, and of course you have your drum battle.
Yeah, the short one, which is fun also.
Yeah.
That was very scary the first night, but got through it just about.
How do you go about constructing that? Do you go, right, we've got this gap?
Dan sort of wanted to wing it, which I really didn't want to do.
Okay.
I was sort of kind of...
Well, he's got 40 years experience.
Yeah, playing an arena tour. Of course. But, you know, he's... Yeah, and I was a lot more nervous, obviously, I think. But I just wanted to sort of set out some sort of idea that we could, you know, carry on doing. But we've been changing it up a little bit here and there. I just feel it's better if you stick to it.
No. But you're clearly enjoying yourself, though, aren't you, on this tour?
Having a ball.
On and off stage, you know.
Say no more.
Yeah, indeed. Romantic, can we do it again? Can we do it again sometime? I like that. Woohoo! Seaside rendezvous. Give us a kiss.